McLaren Formula One have revealed a special one-off Gulf livery for the Monaco Grand Prix, and this is my attempt to recreate it in Gran Turismo Sport. Let's get started with the time-lapse. If you enjoy the video, please be sure to subscribe. We're starting off by painting the main body in blue and the rest of the parts in black. Ever since I did the McLaren Sabre LMH video, I've been thinking of doing a Gulf livery on an F1 car. This was the perfect opportunity, and I think McLaren themselves have pulled off the look really well. I think it's pretty unanimous among the entire F1 community that McLaren should use this livery for the whole season. The Gulf livery has so much heritage, and it would be awesome to see it stay on an F1 car. Unfortunately, it's just a one-off for the Monaco Grand Prix. The Super Formula shape is actually quite different to a modern F1 car. While most of the lines from an F1 car usually carry over to the Super Formula, there are some lines which I have to adjust or adapt in order to exactly suit the shape of the car. This car isn't the first F1 car to use a Gulf livery, nor is it the first McLaren to use a Gulf livery. Both versions of the McLaren F1 GTR had a Gulf livery, and so did the Scuderia Gulf Rondini of 1976. We're just getting started with the sponsors on this car. Zak Brown has done a great job of securing sponsors for McLaren, and that makes my job as a livery creator a little more difficult. I've tried to get all the sponsors I could find, but I might have missed a few minor sponsors here and there. It's honestly astonishing how many sponsors there are though. While the Monaco circuit hasn't traditionally been favorable to the McLaren, I think that they can actually do well there, and maybe there's even a chance of a podium. We're now just finishing up with some of the minor sponsors, the finishing touches and the small details. Now that the livery is done, let's see it in action on track. Since the Monaco circuit isn't in the game, I've had to make do with Interlagos.